you know, the soap opera, as the world turns, as the weather turns, so too do the fates and fortunes of tri-state football teams. With George, I'm Ken. We assume you know who you are. Welcome to another edition of High School Playbook.
Yes, and everything old is new again.
Seems that way.
We're getting a little poetic here tonight. We might want to tone it down.
It's Friday.
Well, the Greater Miami Conference, it's at least a co-championship trophy once again for the Colerain Cardinals. They just won't go away in that conference. It was the scene of our Pontiac tailgate. Lakota West hosting the mighty Cardinals. Colerain off and running early. Tyler Williams continuing his fine season. He rolls in for the touchdown. Nice move. Cut back, and he's in. 7-0 Cardinals. Then a little later, guess what?
What?
It's Williams again. What a game he had. 151 yards rushing and 3 touchdowns. Lakota West then gets the offense on track. Steven Houston. This is an impressive touchdown run.
He's going to Mississippi, right?
Yep, like going to Ole Miss, and that's why. But it's Colerain winning 35-13. If the Cardinals beat Oak Hills next week, they win the GMC outright.
Our pick game of the week in Hamilton. The Big Blue against the Middletown Middies alumni and cheerleader night in Hamilton. And the Big Blue's Drew Townsend caught up in the moment, handing the ball off to Devin Jarrett, who storms up the middle for the Hamilton touchdown. Middletown figured its best route to a win in this game was in the air. Caleb Watkins goes airborne here to Nick McKnight. Good night. It's a Middletown touchdown. But Townsend was on his game, and the Hamilton quarterback struts his stuff. This touchdown pass to Arius Turner. And Hamilton denies Middletown a piece of the GMC title with a 34-14 win.
What a job by Jim Place, huh? Steve Chanel brought his Edgewood squad to Shea Stadium in Norwood, a big home game for the Indians. Edgewood's Bryant French. French fries the Norwood defense like he was shot out of a cannon. 7-0 Cougars. Norwood's Neil Tenbrink goes play action. Airs this puppy out to Seth Kirby. Wow, nice work there. Game tied at 7. Edgewood coming right back. Brandon Markham keeps it. Calls his own number. He's in for the touchdown, 34-24. Edgewood now leading the Scarlet Division of the FAVC.
It was showdown night in the Southern Buckeye Conference. New Richmond with 1 defeat on its record at Western Brown. With a Broncos strike first, Sean Davis drops it, gathers it. Look at him go. Western Brown trying to win its first division title outright, zooms to a quick lead. Ah, but the Lions knew going into this game, win and you share that title. So Andrew Nealon did his part, tying this game at 7. And then on New Richmond's next possession, Steven Gantzler with the touchdown. And it's Western Brown winning it outright.
Wow.
28-14 is the win. Time now for the most important part of the program, I Eat Free. We're here at Lakota West High School.
Lakota and I'm West.
Yes.
Darlene Mack.
Darlene's in charge here. Darlene, I'm hungry. It's Friday night. It's football. What do I want to eat here?
Well, we got our famous Firebird hot dogs. We've got Mets, brats, hamburgers, cheeseburgers, Chick-fil-A, you name it, we got it. You're probably better off with the cheeseburger. Let's get a cheeseburger.
Let's get a cheeseburger.
It's here called a cheeseburger. It's called Ken Eats Free Food.
Oh, yeah.
Let's have a hand for it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Excellent. They soak those in Worcestershire sauce.
I missed out on that. I went for the Skittles.
Oh, it was unbelievable. Yeah. It was wonderful. It was free. It's another big week of votes for our Cincinnati Bell wild card game. What? 109,000 votes?
How about that?
That's more than decided the 1960 presidential election. Over 45,000 to the winner.
Yes, Waynesville and Monroe were crashing our mainframe here in Mount Auburn this week. Waynesville had a big lead at the half over Monroe. Monroe trying to get on track. Mike Wilkerson isn't going to let that happen. The big man gets a little sackage there. Monroe will get this next pass off, but it is that Waynesville defense. Brady Dieters, he's on the spot almost with the interception. The Waynesville D taking complete control in this second half. Seth Miller knocking this pass down. Waynesville with a winner in the wild card, 23-7.
Submitted for your approval, this edition of our latest round of wild card games. Only one can win. I hope you know the drill. Go to WLWTHighSchoolPlaybook.com. And vote whoever wins the most, I mean, whoever gets the most votes by close of business next Friday, well, you wind up on the playbook next Friday night at 11:15.
Just like Monroe and Waynesville did tonight.
109,000 votes.
Yeah, how about that?
It's amazing. Straight ahead on this edition of High School Playbook. No Carson Palmer this Sunday. No Carson Palmer next week against the Texans.
And no game better than the one we have so deemed our head-to-head game of the week. When we turn the page on another edition of High School Playbook.